guys, Risque here, and welcome back to Mafia 3. So last we left off, we were clearing out these Southern Union assholes. Getting fairly close to finishing them off, I'm pretty sure. Ooh. This is too revealing, I don't like it. Oh. Okay, well thankfully they were oblivious that time. It's okay, I can't tell. Okay, no, I don't think the sentry's in this room. Come on.
What?
That works. I like it. Okay. That was perfect timing for me to hide. Points to me. Love it. Go me.
Maybe I should look over there.
Do y'all ever remember, London from Sweet Life of Zack and Cody, and how she was always like, "Yay me!" I'm like, I need to be more like London, because she was always so happy, and like she loved herself. And I'm just like, what is that like? You're not gonna believe who came by. Mr. Remy Duval himself told us to stay strong, keep up the fight. That the tide is starting to turn. God bless that man. This country may have turned its back on the white man, but Remy Duval is still standing with us. And there are still people today who actually believe that bullshit. But that's not what this video is about, so let me calm down. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Don't even think about it. Okay, that was kind of badass though. Killed him with his own gun. Love that. Oh, I don't want that gun. Never mind. I thought it was like a tack vest or something, which wouldn't make sense because I already have a tack vest anyway, so wouldn't have mattered.
Thank you.
Of course. Happy to help. Happy to do anything I can. Okay. Rob the coyote. The sick motherfucker stashed his cash while he's out on a run. But don't get cocky. There's no telling what could happen out there. And then the faucets. Oh, there are more of them. Okay, I want to go do that. Oh, but I only need $700 more, and that's closer, so. Sorry to the other victims. I'll have somebody go out there. Sorry. That's horrible, I know, but I'm like, I want to go ahead and wrap this up while I can. And I'd rather go the route that's quickest. Because honestly, I was really kind of annoyed with how long it took me to do everything I did in my downtime, because I'm just like, I had to do it in my downtime, because I just feel like it's so boring for you guys to have to watch me do the same shit over again, like, repeatedly. And I noticed that for those missions for Nikki, Emmanuel, and Alma, they send you to the same two places repeatedly. That also, like, really, like, kind of pissed me off. I was like, you've got to be kidding me. Okay, can everybody move, please? And yeah, we'll be back to this place to finish the cult mission, because that one actually is pretty interesting. I think we just kept dying and I was over it. But we're a little better off now. Enough time has passed that I think we should get through the rest of it pretty easily. Provided there's not, like, 1,000 more steps to it before we do finish it. Because, you know, I don't trust this game anymore. I don't trust this game to not do a bunch of unnecessary. Okay. Rob the coyote. I'm just nervous. When they were like, "Be on your toes, you never know what might happen." I'm like, what does that mean? Like, I know I'm just gonna have to fight a bunch of fucking assholes out here. Not looking forward to that. Okay, mine. Also mine. Sweet. Aw, shit. Oh, they know I'm here. They already know I'm here. Oh, Oh my god, Lincoln, could you miss anymore? And I mean, whenever I complain about Lincoln missing, it's mainly me for not aiming well. Need a second to reload. Y'all's pathing is really fucking weird. Okay. One down, two to go. Oh, for fuck's sake. Come on. Stand up. Oh my god, how many shots does it take to kill your ass? Okay, you're the main one I'm worried about. Fuck you. Cool. Give me all of your money. You don't need any of it. And honestly, I need to call the concierge and drop all my shit off. Because yeah, whenever I level this up a bunch with the arms dealer, I spent a bunch of money doing that. So I'm a little broker than I was when we played last time. Alrighty. Let's go. Lego. My forever speech about how much I hate Chris Brown, but man, I love to break into that song whenever I say let's go. And I know if Mosey was here, she would join me. We would sing it together, as much as we hate Chris Brown. But yeah, I can't believe there are actually still people out there that support his ass. Like, love him. And I'm just like, why? Especially women that love him. Why? Because first of all, okay, he's not as cute as he was when he was younger. Like, maybe it's just me and not finding abusers hot, but seriously, it's been some rough years for him and his shows. But his music isn't that good anymore. Like, I don't remember, I think the last song he released that I liked was Party. Back in 2017? Or 2016. It might be 2016. Either way, it was a long ass time ago. I mean, shit, that's when I released my album. So it's been that long. But yeah, so. Anyway, that's my rant. I can't stand his ass, and I don't understand people that can. So I'm like, ladies, you know he's trying to beat us all up, right? You've pulled.
You can find Chester Moreau at the grocery store.
How'd you find him?
I had a hunch, so I sat on an apartment in the French ward that's listed under his youngest kid's name. Fucker's been holed up there. He slipped back into Frisco with some cronies in tow. I think he figures if Olivia doesn't get to him, you will.
You all right?
Fuck no. Those poor people. I've got an old friend from the State Department who's going to help them. But Moreau, that asshole Remy Duval, they've got to answer for what they've done. All of it.
They will. You have my word.
Jesus. When I found out what they were doing, you have to stop Moreau.
You can count on me, Jackie? Is that her name? You can count on me, girly pop. Let me go ahead and call the concierge. I'm in Frisco. It'll just make me feel better. Cash
off me. Hold your horses, I'll get to you.
Hey, girl, hey! Thank you. I just don't want to lose that much cash. Excuse me, lady. Shouldn't have been in the way. It's your own fault. You should sit there and think about what you've done. You inconvenienced me, and that's really the crime. Man, if people like... For people who don't know, I am, like, incredibly sarcastic. So, like, please don't take most of the shit I say seriously. Like, when I'm being serious, I think it's fairly obvious to know versus when I'm being sarcastic. Like, I feel like I have a very different tone when I'm being serious, so, like, please don't think that I'm actually a horrible person that believes most of the stuff I say. Because I don't, I swear. This hair won't stop getting in my face. It's really sad, because I really like this wig, but it's already kind of in rough shape, and I really can't afford another one right now, so we're just gonna have to work with it. This is gonna be rough, but I think we can do it. Moreau's our main target. We can't get distracted. I'm just like, how did they wait, maybe this door was open the whole time. That's very possible. Very possible, actually.
That nigga be stupid to come around here. All these men, all these guns. Fuck. His ass would be dead before he knew what hit him.
Just keep that thing loaded. Last thing we should do is underestimate this asshole.
Listen to your friend. Glad I killed him first. He seemed to be the smart one of the group. How many people can see me in this room? Okay, there's just these two. Cool. I can handle that. I can handle that. I just like to know what I'm up against. Go ahead and get my knives. I'll take this guy out. And then taking the sentry out will be a little easier. Shit. Don't even fucking think about it. Asshole. Okay, I shouldn't have to worry about the guys outside, I don't think, so I'm not going out that way. Okay, somebody's coming downstairs. Nope. Never mind, you changed your mind. That is totally okay. It's okay when people change their minds. Okay, I think you're isolated. That makes that easier. So I'm like, how close together is everybody up here? That's what I don't know, and that's what's kind of making me a little nervous. Okay. These guys are by themselves. He's got that guy with him. Shit, there's not really a good place to hide. Shit. Okay. This works for me. Just please do come all the way downstairs. I would like to take care of you as soon as possible. Hell yeah. Okay, so that one guy's left, and I think there's a sentry in there too. Fuck. You know what? Let's go this way. God, there are like 1,000 birds outside making noise, so sorry if it's bothering you. It's not really much I can do about it, unfortunately. Okay, so this guy's here. The sentry's there. Noted. I just don't want to risk. I don't want to risk the sentry catching me kill the other guy. Shit.
Something's going down.
You saw fucking nothing. Don't you ever forget it. Nothing, I say. A lot of bigwigs are coming to town for this, and they're expecting quality product. Bring me the best you got. Get them nice and cleaned up so they're presentable. Fuck this up and it's your ass. Miss Marcano already warned you once. She ain't gonna do it a second time. Miss Marcano can suck my clit. That's what I had to say about Miss Marcano. Fuck her. I mean, at least he's not a sentry. But I think that's the only way to these guys. You know what?
I'll figure out what's up with that smoke.
And if everybody could get involved, that would be really cool. And then I can just torch all of your asses. I'll wait for this guy to get involved, and then it'll just be me and Chester. Me and Chuck. Me and Chad. There we go. That's exactly what I was hoping for. It's rare my plans actually ever work out the way I intend for them to. Alright, come on, you racist prick. That's what I fucking thought. Die, please.
You do whatever you want. I'll do whatever you want. Just don't kill me.
But what I want is for you to die.
Yup. Damn. Just fucking badass. All right. Okay, no. I promised it to Burke. It's going to Burke. Yeah, he's the only one that doesn't control three districts.
Took down Bel Air and Frisco Fields. Just so we're clear, we'll not be using this place to fucking sell people. Find another way to make money from it.
No worries, lad. They're on their way. Hold tight.
You know, I would hope that Burke didn't need to be told that. Especially when I saw slave trade come up, I was a little concerned. I was like, surely we're gonna use this for something else. But okay, good deal. Because I mean, I know Lincoln wasn't about to allow that shit. But it's just like, Burke is such a wild card. That's like, I would think he wouldn't, but you never really know. Okay, sweet. So, let's go ahead and get started on PCP. I don't feel like doing that. Not about it. Like, I got a little irritated even just seeing that pop up. Not gonna lie. Okay, anyway, before I lose it, before I lose my marbles. Okay, this is how a supermarket should be run.
Watch it.
Sorry, lady. None personal. Okay. Let's get started on PCP. Talk to Bear. Aw. Talking to Bear again. I do like revisiting the people we have visited in the past. Okay. Turn this shit around. How far away is good old Bear. And Bear is a little far. Yeah, that's kind of a drive I was not expecting. But okay, we might go ahead and take out Olivia in this episode. Or not this episode, but in this session. Which would be cool, because the next session I can just focus on all the small stuff. I can focus on finishing up the Alma thing, which I could have sworn I already did. Like, I remember it saying, Racket's at max earn for that. I could have sworn. But I mean, maybe after finishing Vito's thing, they gave me more, I don't know. But it's just like, it's so redundant. And I don't like that. I do not like redundancy. Okay, Bear. Let's do this thing. Which actually, geographically, this makes a lot of sense. Like, we kind of switched things up with downtown and the French Ward. But we did good concerning Burke. He's pretty much in one place, and I mean, I guess this stuff... What's that? Oh, it's for Alma. I guess this stuff isn't ever gonna belong to us, which is fine with me, quite honestly. I don't feel like doing that or the Stones Unturned thing. I'm like, why couldn't enough just be enough, you know? We didn't need the extra. Like, the original missions were extra enough as it is, and I get it, it's DLC, and it was probably paid DLC at the time it came out, so I get it. Should I say hi to Donovan while we're here? But at the same time, I feel bad for the people who spent their money on it, because it's just like, it didn't add anything for me.
Greetings and salutations. And all that shit.
Yeah, it's been a while. How you been?
Long way from Point Verdun, aren't you, Bear?
Decided it was time to branch out. Not really a lot for me in that organization anymore.
So what's your new line?
Mind-melting narcotics. And I hear the best are coming out of Frisco. PCP. And it's cutting into my business.
Okay. So where's the operation?
Beats the hell out of me. But a while back, Miss Olivia Marcano hired a top-notch chemist named Bobby Bastian. Tasked him with upgrading her operations, which will make it impossible for the small-time cooks to compete. Hell, they even got taxis delivering their shit.
If I can get to Bastian's dealers, maybe they'll give him up. Tell me something I can use against him.
That ain't all. Word is Miss Marcano brought in a couple other eggheads from San Francisco. Get rid of them, and Bobby Bastian's gonna find himself nice and fucked. Bit of beating on some of Bastian's guys, and maybe they'll tell you something useful.
All right. It's just the same shit. Bastian's taxi service delivers speed to bored housewives, killing any dealers you find out in the street. I'm not doing any of that. Just so you know, I don't care enough. I will do what they put on the map for me to do. Alright, let's interrogate, and then we have a few people to kill. I just think, like, one racket per district would have been perfect. Because, you know, we get a feel of the land. And, you know, they could have made each district, or each racket, maybe a little fuller. And then that way, it wouldn't have felt like overkill by having to do two rackets in each district and having it be just like the same, you know, interrogate slash kill slash steal slash rob slash destroy over and over again, you know? I think this game, they were very creative in a lot of the things they did, and I respect the hell out of them for that. But I think the execution wasn't always the best. No. That would not be smart. Which I think that might have been one of the cars I needed to blow up or whatever. Whoop.
It's not gonna be me doing the talking.
There's really no easy way out of this one. Cause like everybody's like grouped up together. Well, maybe, hold on. Oh, I forgot there was explosives! Shit. 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 There we go. The fuck he is. Shit. Shit. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it.
Keep your narrow ass in that seat.
Oh, hold it! Who the fuck invited you?
Tell me about Bastian's PCP business.
I was really hoping to...
Oh, you barely missed Stop the car! Stop the car!
Nope.
Spill, let's go.
I was really hoping to not have to do this.
Tell me what I need to know.
Let me out! Let me out!
Don't be shy. Talk to me.
Oh my god, all these turns can suck it. Okay, here we go. Let's get on a bridge. You better start talking. Spill the beans. Spill your guts. I'm not playing with you.
I can't tell you my folks dropped me on my head. I don't remember shit.
Well, too bad.
Cocksucker! We've been moving the speed around town using taxis. Last I heard, the boss was keeping the cash drops at the dispatch garage.
I see you again. It's your ass.
So yeah, keep your fucking mouth shut. Okay, how far? That's not too bad. And okay, we only have to get 50,000 this time. I can handle that. That's a little more reasonable. I ain't mad. I like this car though. I kind of want to keep it. Like, is this a model that I have in my vehicle delivery? Because it kind of feels kind of sportsy, but I don't know. Woohoo! Okay, that was fun. No, okay, so when I was younger, my mom's fiance's family lived like out in the country or whatever. And so we'd go to visit them, and sometimes we'd take this path or the street, or this road, I guess, is the better term. And it had, like, this really big, like, hill. And so, like, sometimes we'd go, like, kind of fast on it and then, like, catch a little bit of air, and we called it Tickle Belly Road, because, like, it felt like a roller coaster. Like, you would get the butterflies. So, yeah, a little story time. Okay. Who's a baddie? Who's irrelevant? I just see that guy over there. I'm not sure what all he can see, but I don't want to risk him seeing me killing one of these guys. Which, actually, we're going to kill these guys in the next episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, share this with your friends, hit the bell so you don't miss an upload, and I'll see you guys next time.